हेलो एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ महेश, लेक्चरर इन मैकेनिकल डिपार्टमेंट, गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक कालगी. सो इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस फ्यू प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया, दैट इज़ यूनिट टू, स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल्स, थर्ड सेमेस्टर मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग. सो इन दिस सेशन वी विल कवर प्रॉब्लम ऑन आई सेक्शन एंड प्रॉब्लम ऑन चैनल सेक्शन. So begin with the first problem. An I section has following details. Find the moment of inertia of the section about the horizontal axis passing through the centroidal axis. So we have the dimensions like top flange is 100 mm into 20 mm, web section 20 mm into 100 mm, bottom flange 200 mm into 20 mm. So according to the given dimension, first we have to draw the sketch, that is top flange as 100 mm into 20 mm, okay. Then the web section, it is 20 mm width and 100 mm depth, and the bottom flange is again 200 mm width and 20 mm depth. So after drawing this complete section, okay, we can understand the given figure is symmetrical about YY axis. The given figure is symmetrical about the YY axis. Therefore, center of gravity will lie on this axis. So, center of gravity of this whole section will lie on this axis because it is symmetric about the Y section. That is a mirror image, or it is same both side. We can have same images about the symmetric axis. Now what we will do, we will divide the whole section into three rectangles, that is rectangle 1, 2 and 3. This is the rectangle 1, this is the rectangle 2 and this is the rectangle 3. Now consider rectangle 1. So this is the rectangle 1. So now calculate the area of the rectangle 1, that is A1 is equal to 200 into 20, which is equal to 4000 millimeter square. Now calculate distance Y1. Y1 is the distance from the reference axis, that is from bottommost portion of the section, that is we have considered as axis 1, 1. This is the reference axis. From this reference axis to the center of gravity of the rectangle 1, that is point G1, okay. We have identified it as G1, so that is the center of gravity of the rectangle 1, okay. So Y1 is the distance between the reference axis and the center of gravity of the rectangle 1, that is 20 divided by 2, which is equal to 10 millimeters. Now consider rectangle 2 and calculate the area of rectangle 2, that is 100 into 20, which is equal to 2000 mm square, okay. And now calculate distance y2. Y2 is the distance from the reference axis 1, 1 to the center of gravity of the second rectangle, okay. So center of gravity of the rectangle 2 is g2, okay. From g2 to the reference axis, this distance is y2, which is equal to 20 plus 100 divided by 2, which is equal to 70 millimeters, okay. Now we will move on to the third rectangle. Consider this rectangle and find out the area. This is the third rectangle with dimension 100 into 20, so your area will be 2000 millimeter square, okay. And what will that be the distance y3 from reference axis to the center of gravity of the third rectangle, that is from point g3 to the reference axis 1, 1. So this will be 20 plus 100, from here to here 20, here to here 100, and for this rectangle it is half of the depth, that is 20 by 2. So 20 plus 100 plus 20 by 2, which is equal to 130 millimeters. Now we have to calculate the moment center of gravity for the whole section. That is, y bar is the center of gravity of this complete section. Okay, it is measured from again reference axis 1 1. So we have to calculate using the equation a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3. Substitute the values of a1 y1, a2 y2, and a3 y3. So that is, after substitution you will get, and calculate this equation or solve this equation, you will get the result as y bar is equal to 55 millimeters. So this is the distance y bar, and this is the g, which is the center of gravity of the I section, okay, which lie on again yy axis. Distance is 55 millimeter from the reference axis 1 1. Now we will calculate the moment of inertia about xx axis. Okay, so to calculate moment of inertia, first we need to calculate the moment of inertia of each rectangle. Okay, individually we will calculate the moment of inertia, then we will add all the moment of inertias to get the moment of inertia about the xx axis. Xx axis is a horizontal axis which is passing through the center of gravity of the section. Okay, so this g is the center of gravity of the I section, and xx is the horizontal axis passing through that center of gravity. So we have to calculate moment of inertia about xx axis. Okay, so now for the first rectangle we can calculate ig1. It is the moment of inertia of the rectangle 1, by which is given by a formula b1 d1 cube divided by 12. b1 is the width, that is 200, and d1 is the depth of the rectangle 1, that is 20. So b1 is 200, d1 is 20. Substitute b1 and d1, you will get the moment of inertia of the rectangle 1 as 133.333 into 10 to the power 3 mm to the power 4. Now we will calculate distance between center of gravity of rectangle 1, center of gravity of rectangle 1, and the xx axis. That is, this distance, which is named as h1, which is equal to y bar minus y1, that is 55 minus 10. You will get answer as 45 millimeters. So this is the distance between the center of gravity of rectangle 1 and the center of gravity of the whole section, that is xx axis. So you will get 45 millimeters. Now we will calculate moment of inertia of rectangle 1 about xx axis. That is, by using the parallel axis theorem, ig1x is equal to ig1 plus a1 into h1 square. So the moment of inertia of this plus the area of this section into the distance between the axis, okay, in square, that is h1 square. Okay, substitute the values of ig1, a1, and h1. Okay, so after substitution and calculation, you will get the value of ig1 or i1x is equal to 8.233 into 10 to the power 6 mm to the power 4. Now moving on to the second rectangle, again we have to calculate moment of inertia of rectangle 2 about an axis through its cg. Again we have to calculate the moment of inertia of rectangle 2 about xx axis. Okay, now we will calculate the self moment of inertia of rectangle 2. Moment of inertia of rectangle 2 is b2 d2 cube divided by 12. Here b2 is the width of this web section, that is 20, and 100 is the, or d2 is the depth of the web section, that is 100. So 20 into 100 cube divided by 12, it will give you 1.666 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter to the power 4. Now we will calculate distance between the center of gravity of rectangle 2 and the xx axis. this distance we have to calculate. That is, it is denoted by h2. h2 is equal to y bar minus y2. Okay. So 55 minus 70. Okay, 70 is the value of y2, and you will get minus 15 millimeters. Now the moment of inertia of rectangle to about xx axis is given by ig2. X is equal to ig2 plus a2 into h2 square, again using the parallel axis theorem. Substitute the values of ig2, a2 and h2, you will get the answer as 2.11 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter to the power 4. Okay, now we have to calculate for the third rectangle, that is moment of inertia of rectangle 3 about xx axis. So we can calculate by the formula ig3 is equal to b3 d3 cube by 12. Here in the rectangle 3, this is b3, that is the width of the rectangle 3 as 100 millimeter, and this is d3, it is the depth. Okay, it is 20 millimeters. Substitute the values of b3 and d3, you will get ig3 as 66.666 into 10 to the power 3 millimeter to the power 4. Now the distance between cg of rectangle 3 and xx axis. Okay, so we have to calculate the distance between the center of gravity of the third rectangle and the center of gravity of the whole section, that is g. Okay, that can be denoted by h3. So this is the distance from xx axis to the center of gravity of the third rectangle. So it can be calculated by y bar minus y3. 55 minus 130, it will give minus 75 millimeters. Now we will calculate the moment of inertia of rectangle 3 about xx axis using parallel axis theorem, because both the axes are parallel. So substitute the values of ig3, a3 and h3 in this equation and calculate this. We will get 11.3166 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter to the power 4. Now we have calculated the moment of inertia of each rectangles about xx axis. Now we can add them. Okay, so the total moment of inertia of whole section about xx axis is ixx is equal to ig1x plus ig2x plus ig3x. So substitute the values of each moment of inertia of rectangles. Okay, then you will get the answer as 21.6599 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter to the power 4. So this is your answer, moment of inertia of the whole section about xx axis. Okay, so this completes the first chapter, first problem. Now we will go to the second problem. What is the second problem? Calculate the CG and moment of inertia for a channel section of size 100 into 100 into 20 millimeter about xx and yy axis. So in the previous problem we have calculated only about xx axis. Here we have to calculate about xx as well as yy, because this channel section is not symmetric. Okay, about the yy axis, so we have to calculate about both the axes. Okay, again we will first we will draw the channel section according to the given dimension. So out of 100 into 100, usually the higher dimension is taken along the depth. Okay, so out of these both are same, so we will take as 100 mm depth and 100 mm width, and 20 mm is the thickness of the, which is lowest. Okay, that will be considered as thickness of the section. Okay, so after drawing this channel section, we will divide the channel section into three parts. Okay, first we have divided this as first rectangle and the second rectangle and third rectangle. Okay, we can divide the channel section in another way also. Okay, up to here it can be a first rectangle and complete this as a second rectangle and this as a third rectangle. Okay, so now we have divided in like this. Okay, this is first rectangle, this is second rectangle, and this is the third rectangle. So first we will consider rectangle 1, and we will calculate the area of rectangle 1. That is, A1 is equal to 100 into 20. 100 is the width, 20 is the depth. So we will get 200 mm². Now we will calculate Y1. Y1 is the distance from the reference axis to the center of gravity of the rectangle 1. Okay, this is the center of gravity of rectangle 1, and this is the reference axis. So this distance is Y1. Calculate Y1, which is equal to from here, from reference axis to this point or this line is 80 millimeters. Okay, 100 minus 20, it will give you 80 millimeter plus the half of the depth of this rectangular portion, that is 20 divided by 2, which is equal to 90 millimeters. And now we will calculate x1 distance also, because we need to calculate about yy axis. So x1 is the rectangle, this is the reference axis, that is the leftmost side, left end of the section, that is taken as a reference axis for yy axis. Okay, so this is the reference axis. From this reference axis we have to calculate the distance x1, which is the from point center of gravity of the rectangle 1 to the reference axis, that is x1 is equal to 100 divided by 2, which is equal to 50 millimeters. Now we will calculate for rectangle 2. So this is the rectangle 2. Area of the rectangle is 20 into 60. Okay, 20 is the width, 60 is the height. So 20 into 60, which is equal to 1200 mm². Now the distance y2. Y2 is the distance from the reference axis to the center of gravity of the rectangle 2. This is the center of gravity of rectangle 2. From here we have to calculate the distance from reference axis. So this is your y2, which is equal to 20 plus 60 divided by 2. This is the length of the rectangle 2. So we have to divide it by half, by 2. That is 20 plus 60 by 2 is equal to 50 millimeters. What is x2? x2 is the half of the width of this section, rectangle. Okay, so from here to here, from center of gravity of rectangle 2 to the reference axis, which is equal to x2, 20 by 2, it is 10 millimeters. Consider rectangle 3. Area of the rectangle 3 as 100 into 20, which is equal to 2000 mm², and y3, which is the distance from reference axis to the center of gravity of the third rectangle. So from this point to this reference axis, it is y3, which is equal to 20 divided by 2, which is equal to 10 millimeter. Now we will calculate x3. x3 is from the reference axis, okay, which is parallel to yy, here to center of gravity of the third rectangle. So this is the x3. Okay, this is x3, that is 100 divided by 2, which is equal to 50 millimeters. Now we will calculate the center of gravity of the complete section, that is y bar is equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3. Substitute the values, okay, of a1 y1, a2 y2, a3 y3, and you will get answer as 50 millimeter. Okay, so this is the center of gravity point, which is 50 mm above the reference line, okay, reference axis to the center of gravity. So this is the axis passing through the center of gravity, and this is the reference axis. So distance between these two is 50 millimeter along the vertical direction. Okay, now distance between CG of the section and the left face of the flange. So left face of the flange is, we have again one more reference axis. So from the leftmost side of the flange, it is x bar is equal to a1 x1 a2 x2 plus a3 x3 divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3. So substitute the values of a1 x1 a2 x2 and a3 x3, you will get the value as 40.76. So this is the distance, this is x bar distance, which is from the reference axis to the centroidal axis. Okay, that is x bar is equal to 40.76 millimeters. Now we will calculate moment of inertia about xx axis. This is the first part of the problem, moment of inertia about xx axis. So again, as we solved in the previous problem, we will calculate the moment of inertia of each rectangle. So first we will consider rectangle 1 and calculate the moment of inertia of rectangle 1 about xx axis, that is ix1 is equal to ig1 plus a1 into h1 square using the parallel axis theorem. So ig1 is the b1 into d1 cube divided by 12 plus a1 into y bar minus y1. Okay, so the in this drawing we have h1, we can calculate h1 as the distance between the center of gravity of the whole section to the center of gravity of the rectangle 1. So that is h1. Okay, right, substitute the values. B1 is the width of this rectangle and d1 is the depth of the rectangle 1. B1 is 100, d1 is 20. 100 into 20 cube divided by 12, area is 2000 and y bar is 50 and y1 value is 90. Substitute and you will get ix1 is equal to 3.266 into 10 to the power 6 mm to the power 4. For the second rectangle, now consider the second rectangle ix2, that is the moment of inertia about xx axis for rectangle 2. It is ig2 plus a2 into h2 square. Okay, so h2 is, we have 50 minus 50, it is 0. So h2 lies on, or the, there is no distance, which is 0. Okay, now substitute the values of b2 into d2 cube divided by 12. B2 is the width of this rectangle, that is 20, and depth of the rectangle 2 is 60. Okay, substitute 60 and 20, you will get the answer as 0.36 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter to the power 4. Now consider rectangle 3. We have to calculate the moment of inertia of rectangle 3 about xx axis. So that is ig3 plus a3 into h3 square, parallel axis theorem. So ix3 is equal to, ig3 is b3 into d3 cube. B3 is the width of the rectangle 3, that is 100, and d3 is the depth of the rectangle 3, that is 20. Substitute the values. So h3 is the distance between the center of gravity of the rectangle 3 and the xx axis. Okay, so that is, substitute the values, b is 100, d is 20, okay, and y bar is 50, y3 is 10. So you will get ix3 is equal to 3.266 into 10 to the power 6 mm to the power 4. Now we will calculate the moment of inertia of the complete section about xx axis, that by adding the moment of inertia of rectangle 1, moment of inertia of rectangle 2 and moment of inertia of rectangle 3, ix1 plus ix2 plus ix3. Substitute the values in this equation and solve the equation. You will get ixx is equal to 6.892 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter to the power 4. So this is the moment of inertia of the given section about xx axis. So this is the first part of the problem. Okay, moving on to the second part, that is moment of inertia about yy axis. Okay, so we can calculate, again we will calculate the moment of inertia in of individual rectangles. So it is a easy method. Okay, calculate each moment of inertia of each rectangle and add them to come to get the complete moment of inertia. So iy1 is equal to ig1 plus a1 into h1 square. So this is a parallel axis theorem. So now ig1 is In this case, it will be d1 b1 cube divided by 12. So for the rectangle, one is d1 is 20, depth is 20 and b1 is 100. First substitute the depth value 20 and the width value as 100 meter cube by 12 plus area is 2000 into x bar. Here h1 distance is the distance between the center of gravity of the rectangle 1 and yy axis. So this distance is taken as h1. Okay, substitute the values of x bar and x1, you will get h1, that is 40.76 minus 50 square. After solving this equation, you will get iy1 is equal to 1.837 into 10 to the power 6 mm to the power 4. Okay, now calculate for the rectangle 2. iy2 is equal to ig2 plus a2 into h2 square. h2 is the distance between the center of gravity of the rectangle 2 and the yy axis, which is passing through the center of gravity of the section. So this distance is h2. Okay, it can be calculated by x bar minus x2. So that will give you h2. So iy2 is d2 b2 cube. Here the d2 is 60 and b2 is the width is 20. So 60 into 20 cube divided by 12. Area is 1200, and substitute the values of x bar and x2 and solve this, you will get iy2 is equal to 1.175 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter to the power 4. Now consider the third rectangle. Okay, so calculate the moment of inertia of this rectangle about yy axis by using the formula iy3 is equal to ig3 plus a3 into h3 square. ig3 is d3 into b3 cube divided by 12 plus a3. h3 is the distance between the center of gravity of third rectangle and yy axis. So this will be your h3. Substitute the values. So d3 is depth of the rectangle 3, that is 20, and b3 is the width of the rectangle 3, that is 100. Okay, substitute x bar value and x3 value, you will get iy3 is equal to 1.837 into 10 to the power 6 mm to the power 4. Okay, now what we have to do, we have calculated the moment of inertia of each rectangle about a yy axis. Now we have to add them. So moment of inertia of the whole section, complete section about yy axis is iyy is equal to iy1 plus iy2 plus iy3. Okay, substitute the values of iy1, iy2 and iy3, you will get iyy is equal to 4.849 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter to the power 4. So this will be the moment of inertia of the channel section, given channel section about yy axis. Okay, so this completes the second problem. So this is the end of the session. After this completion of this session, we will be able to calculate the moment of inertia of standard cross sections, that may be L section, T section, I section or channel section, or it is called C section. Okay, now we will go to some questionnaires, that is multiple choice questions. That is question number 1, identify the correct dimension of angle section shown in figure. Okay, you have to identify the dimension, correct dimension of the channel section which is shown in the figure, and you have to mark the correct answer from the given options. So the options are A, 100 into 80 into 20, option B, 100 into 100 into 20, option C, 80 into 80 into 20, option D is none of the above. Okay, you think and answer this question. Okay, we will discuss the answer later. Question number 2, what is the correct dimension of T section shown in the figure? The given T section is like this with the dimensions marked on the in the sketch. So we have to identify the correct dimension, which is correct one. So the options are 250 into 150 into 25, 250 into 175 into 25. One option C is 150 into 250 into 25, and option D is none of the above. Moving on to the third question, find the value of x bar in the given figure. We have to find out the moment center of gravity of the given figure from the reference axis, that is the leftmost portion of the section. Okay, from here to here we have to calculate the distance x bar, that is the center of gravity about yy axis. Okay, you solve this as an activity and check the answer, okay, whether it is correct. Okay, so we will solve this at the end of the session. And the fourth question is, find the total area of the section shown in the figure. Okay, we have given I section with dimensions of the section, okay, top flange, web and the bottom flange. So by using these all dimensions, you have to calculate the total area of the section. It is very simple. Calculate individual areas of the rectangle and add them to get the complete area or total area of the section. Okay, moving on to the fifth question, find the area of the web section from the given T section. We have to find out the area of the web, identify the web and know the dimensions of the web and calculate the area of the web. Okay, so we will discuss the answers in the last slide. Okay, so the answers to this multiple choice question and the activities are, for the question number 1, it is 100 into 80 into 20. Okay, the option A. For question number 2, answer is, you can write down the answers. Question number 2 is 250 into 175 into 25, option B. In question number 3, the value of x bar is, after calculation you will get 35 millimeters. Question number 4, area is equal to 5200 mm square, this is the total area. Question number 5, it is 150 into 25, which is equal to 3750 mm square. Okay, we will go again to the questions. Identify the correct dimension of the angle section. So the answer, correct answer is 100 into 80 into 20, that is option A. Okay, and for the second question, the correct dimension of T section is 250 into 150 plus 25, 175. So 250 into 175 into 25 thickness. So the option B is the correct answer. For the third question, x bar, the value of x bar is 35 millimeters, which can be calculated by using the center of gravity calculation method. Okay, total area of the section can be calculated by adding all the areas. Okay, so the answers for the fourth question is 5200, fifth question is 3750 mm square. Okay, this completes the session. Thank you.